Hello, I'm Francesco De Luca, Senior Researcher at Tallinn University of Technology. I present the work Static Shading Optimization for Glare Control and Daylight. Daylight and sunlight are important factors for building occupants' comfort and for the improvement of their physiological and psychological well-being. Thus, it is crucial to provide adequate quantities of daylight and sunlight in buildings. At the same time, an excess of daylight and sunlight can be a liability because it could hinder occupants' visual comfort through glare effects. Shading devices are an efficient solution to control daylight and sunlight. The most used devices to control glare are interior operable shadings such as roller shades and Venetian blinds, and a large body of scientific literature about their efficacy exists. Nevertheless, they have drawbacks such as the blockage of the exterior view and the increased electric lighting energy consumption due to misuse by the occupants. Exterior static shadings are less performative in reducing glare than the interior shadings, but present advantages such as the constant view to the outside. At the same time, it is still limited, the research about the potential of glare reduction of exterior static shading. The objectives of the study were to investigate the potential of static shading devices to guarantee visual comfort and daylight for entire rooms at northern latitudes, select the most performative shading type for the analyzed building rooms and location, analyze risk for reduced view out and for increased energy consumption. The study was conducted in two classrooms of the Academy of Architecture and Urban Studies of Tallinn University of Technology, characterized by a different orientation, a southerly and an easterly orientation. For the realization of a reliable daylight model, the optical properties of the interior surfaces were measured with a calibrated spectrophotometer, and the glazing visible transmittance was approximated using a lux meter. For the study, four different shading device types were tested: overhang with fins, horizontal louvers, vertical fins, and hexagonal pattern. A parametric model was realized in order to select the most performative static shading for each classroom and its optimal configuration in terms of depth, spacing, and rotation of the elements and aperture. The daylight model was realized in Rhinoceros Grasshopper using the software Climate Studio, which is based on the validated daylight simulation software Radiance. The glare metric used was the spatial discomfort glare based on the daylight glare probability metric, which presents four levels. The spatial discomfort glare assesses the visual comfort in an entire room as a fraction of views which present a daylight glare probability above 0.38, that means disturbing glare, for more than 5% of the occupied hours. Daylight availability was assessed using the metric spatial daylight autonomy, which considers a space adequately daylit if an illuminance of 300 lux is guaranteed during a minimum of 50% of the occupied hours in at least 55% of the regularly occupied floor area. The simulations were conducted using a small and a large grid with different offsets from the walls at approximately half and 1 meter, to analyze the performance of the shading devices with different possible classrooms layout. Multi-objective optimization through the software Opossum in Grasshopper was used to investigate trade-off shading configurations to reduce glare while guaranteeing daylight availability. Analyzing the Pareto front trade-off solutions for classroom 46, we can see that there were large differences in performance between the different shading types. When the large grid was used, the most performative shading was the horizontal louvers with two configurations, which allowed to reduce the glare experienced by 38.4% of the classroom without shading up to 12.7%, which corresponds to a glare reduction of 66.9%. At the same time, the shading allowed a daylight availability of 62.4%, thus significantly larger than the required 55% that is represented by the horizontal line on the charts. The second most performative shading type was the overhang with fins. When the small grid was used, the most performative shading type was the overhang with fin, also with two configurations, which allowed to reduce the glare experienced by 41.7% of the classroom without shading up to 9%, which corresponds to a glare reduction of 78.4%. At the same time, the shading allowed a daylight availability of 55.2%. The second most performative shading type was the horizontal louvers. Analyzing the Pareto front trade-off solutions for classroom 41, the easterly oriented, we can see that the performances of the different shading types were closer comparing the southerly oriented classroom. When the large grid was used, the most performative shading type was the overhang with fin with two configurations, which allowed to reduce the glare experienced by 18.8% of the classroom without shading up to 6.6%, which corresponds to a glare reduction of 64.9%. At the same time, the shading allowed a daylight availability of 55.6%. The second most performative shading type was the hexagonal pattern. When the small grid was used, the most performative shading type was again the overhang with fin with three configurations, which allowed to reduce the glare experienced by 21.1% of the classroom without shading up to 2.9%, which corresponds to a glare reduction of 86.3%. At the same time, the shading allowed a daylight availability of 57.7%. The other most performative shading type for classroom 41 were the hexagonal pattern and the vertical fins. The effect of the static shadings on the viewout was assessed through the sky exposure factor metric. Heating, cooling, and lighting energy consumption were analyzed using the existing building parameters. Results showed that the reduction of viewout was in line with that of daylight availability, and that the increase of energy consumption was modest. The main results of the study are: static shadings reduced disturbing glare by up to 78.4% for the southerly oriented classroom and by up to 86.3% for the easterly oriented classroom. Daylight availability was reduced by 44.8% and 36.9% respectively, but it was still at an adequate level. The shading types horizontal overs and overhang with fins were the best solutions for the southerly oriented classroom, and the overhang with fin and the vertical fins were the best solutions for the easterly oriented classroom. Static shading performed better when was used the small grid, which represents a compact table layout. The reduction of viewout was in line with that of daylight availability, and the increase of energy consumption was modest. Thus, it is possible to state that the reduction of glare by static shading outperforms daylight and viewout reduction and energy increase. For future work of the research, additional shading types, class size, and orientation will be used to obtain larger datasets to be used as guidelines by architects and designers. And viewout and energy analysis will be included in the multi-objective optimization process to minimize the impact of the static shading devices on the viewout reduction and on the energy consumption increase. Thank you very much for the attention.